Nepal's social and political development has been highly progressive. The recent landmark elections held in 2017 have resulted in nearly 40,000 women elected to federal, provincial, and local offices. To continue building upon these gains, Nepal has embraced a commitment to advance the implementation of the Sustainable Development Goals under the principle of leaving no one behind. Toward this end, Nepal has integrated the SDG goals and indicators in its current 14th three-year plan. In 2017, Nepal presented the voluntary national review of the implementation of the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development in the United Nations High-Level Political Forum. The Government of Nepal also published the SDG status and roadmap 2016 to 2030, which highlighted the major opportunities and challenges that the country needs to reckon with in pursuit of the SDGs and in monitoring the implementation of the national commitments from equity and gender equality perspectives. The National Planning Commission, NPC, is the government body responsible for planning, budgeting, coordinating, and monitoring the implementation of the SDGs. In 2016, under the leadership of the NPC, the government of Nepal adopted the Integrated National Evaluation Action Plan of Nepal 2016 to 2020. It aims to achieve concerted efforts among various agencies in Nepal to strengthen the national evaluation capacity, institutionalize equity-focused and gender-responsive SDG evaluation, and produce evaluation-based evidences for better targeting and effective implementation of SDGs.
National Evaluation Plan is a very big achievement for building accountability, learning, and overall transparency culture in Nepal. I think we're particularly excited to see that National Evaluation Plan has a gender and equity perspective embedded in it. In the context of Sustainable Development Goals, this plan could be one of the key drivers for learning as well as for data collection.
The National Evaluation Action Plan consists of five major pillars and respective activities with time frame, lead, and support agencies along with expected outputs.
This plan has five main objectives. One is to establish enabling environment by way of formulating and enacting required national policies, legislation, rules and guidelines, and frameworks for the enhancement of quality evaluations at both the national and subnational levels. Second one is to promote capacity development of professionals who conduct evaluations themselves, as well as those who commission and use the result of evaluations. The third objective is to enhance networking among those who are concerned with evaluations for better coordination and mutual learning. The fourth objective is to promote major monitoring and evaluation activities, including those which are related to SDGs. And lastly but not the least, documentation, dissemination, and the use of evaluations is also very important to make evaluations as truly an integrated part of informed policy and decision-making in public sectors.
The plan was developed through the collaborative work of multiple stakeholders. NPC worked closely with the National Parliamentarian Forum on Development Evaluation Policy in Nepal, voluntary organizations of professional evaluators, and UN agencies from the inspection to the finalization of the plan. It was informed by the results of a series of consultative activities with line ministries, Central Bureau of Statistics, development partners, civil society groups, academia, and professional evaluators.
This integrated action plan that we are doing here is a part of collaboration among stakeholders, government and other stakeholders. So to me, consultation process, collaboration is the first thing that we should do, inviting different groups of people, not only from the center but also provincial and local level, so that evaluation evidences can be cascaded and used in sub-national level planning process as well. It should be evolved through consultative processes, it should be equity focused and gender responsive, and it should be adopted by the government. That is also critical. Be approved by the government so that it will be owned by all actors.
The plan will come up with stronger policies, including a national law on monitoring and evaluation, high-value knowledge products and information, tools, technology, and expertise, which will help advance an enabling environment for the institutionalization of SDG evaluation, network, and coordination for strengthening capacities to monitor and evaluate SDGs at the national and subnational levels, particularly from the perspective of social inclusion and gender equality. These outcomes have been helping to enhance the capacity of national evaluators for the country-led and evidence-based policy-making and effective implementation of the evaluation evidences and lessons learned to achieve inclusive, gender-responsive, and equity-focused development that will leave no one behind.